everybody. Welcome to Model Maths Nagarasar YouTube channel. Please like, subscribe and click bell button and share with your friends. Today in this class we are going to learn intermediate first year mathematics 1A, fourth chapter, addition of vector, part 2. Very short questions. So in part 1 also we have discussed what is introduction, what do you mean by addition of vectors, what are the main points, how to find unit vector, how to find some lambda and mu values when two vectors are collinear. Those are very important questions. That's what taught in the previous part 1. So then after that, continuation of part 1 is part 2. In this also, we are going to learn some more 2 marks important questions. Okay. Through this part 1 and part 2, we can complete all 2 marks questions. We can easily get 2 marks questions. Okay. So actually, for the chapter, in this chapter, 2 marks question, 1 4 marks question. That is, we have in the syllabus. Okay, see points one by one. The most important formulas. From these all 5 concepts, 1 question is compulsory in the exam. Okay, what are the 5 concepts? Then how can we apply in the next questions? First of all, see the concepts. First one, the vector equation passing through 2 points A of A and B of B is what? So here point is means A of A. A means some vector, some 3i plus 2j plus n like that. So formula is 1 minus t into A plus t into B bar. Okay. This is the vector equation passing through 2 points. What is that? 1 minus t into A plus t into B. So here A and B are 2 points, represent vectors. And what is t? T is some real number. Means when we write in the answer, t means t only we will write. And A and B means we can write a given from the question. Okay, first listen the formula. What is formula of vector equation passing through 2 points? Yes, what is formula? 1 minus t, sorry, r equal 1 minus t into A bar plus t into B bar. Similarly, you see the second formula. The vector equation passing through 3 points. What are those 3 points? A of A, B of B and C of C is, you can write 1 minus t minus s into A bar plus t into B bar plus some s into C bar. What about t and s? T comma s belongs to real numbers. So this is the second more formula. Second formula. What is the vector equation passing through 3 points? 1 minus t minus s into A bar plus t into B bar plus s into C bar. Okay. Vectors look like it is a theory, but it is not a theory. It is also a problematic. Okay. Next, third one. The vector equation passing through the point A of A, point A of A and parallel to vector B bar. See, point is can be denoted as some capital A of small a. Vector means simply we can write small b bar like. Is what? Okay. So here we should write a vector equation which is passing through point and parallel to some another vector. That is R equal to A plus t into b bar. What about t? T is belongs to real number. Means, okay, this condition also we must write, but we should remember this always. Next, the vector equation passing through A of A and parallel to B and C is r bar equal to what? So here passing through 1 point, okay, that is A, and parallel to B and C means TB plus SC. Same. Passing through point A, parallel to B means only A plus TB. Passing through A, parallel to B and C means TB plus SC. So what about T and S? Yes, T and S belongs to real numbers. This condition also we should write. Next, the last statement is, the vector equation passing through A of A and B of B and parallel to C bar. Here passing through 2 points and parallel to third vector. See, passing through 2 points, what is the equation? 1 minus t into A plus tb. Okay? I am writing first that passing through 2 points equation. 1 minus t into A plus t into B. Next, parallel to C bar. Parallel to C bar means, we can additionally write tb or sc. Already t is there. So, we have to write a third vertex vector. That is, we can write a sc. That is, small sc. Okay? This is formula of last one. So where t comma s belongs to real number. So these are the important key points Let us see how we can apply these formulas in the very short questions. See, once again, passing through two points, 1 minus t into a plus tb. Passing through 3 points, 1 minus t minus s into a plus tb plus sc. Passing through 1 point and parallel to vector, so a plus 2b. This is passing through 1 point and parallel to two vectors, tb plus sc. This is passing through 2 points, so 2 points equation and parallel equation, okay? So, by hand, without any confusion, we can apply in the questions. See, in this concept first question, actually in part 1 we completed 7 very short questions. So next onwards, means from 8th, find the vector equation of the line joining the points 2i plus j plus 3k and minus 4i plus 3j minus k. See here, how many points are given joining the points 1 and 2. So given that the one point is capital E of A, so that is 2i plus j plus 3k, and the second point is B of B is minus 4i plus 3j minus k. So, 2 points are given. What is the equation? Yes, 1 minus t into a plus tb. Very good. So, the equation of vector equation passing through 2 points. What are the a of a and b of b? Is what is some r bar equal to 1 minus t into a plus t into b. Okay, is it vector equation? Yes. Now substitute, what is a, what is b? What is t? T belongs to real number, therefore r equal 1 minus t into a. A means what? A means the first vector, that is 2i plus j plus 3k, and plus tb, so means t into b. B means what? Minus 4i plus 3j minus k, where t belongs to r. Simple, this is the answer. Okay, if you want more explanation, we can write one more steps also. If you write up to here also, we will be awarded the marks, no problem. And next simplification, here I coefficient is 1 minus 2 into 2, 1 minus t into 2, so that is 2 minus 2t. Here I coefficient is minus 4 into t, that is minus 4t i. Next, j coefficient. Here j coefficient is 1 minus t into j. So 1 minus t is the j coefficient. Here j coefficient is 3 into t, 3t. So j coefficients are like this. And k coefficients. So here k coefficient is 3 into 1 minus t. 3 into 1 minus t means 3 into 3. 3, 3 into minus t, minus t. Here k coefficient is minus 1 into t, minus t. Into k. What about t? T belongs to real number. So finally, two t terms here, minus 2 are there, here minus 4 are there, so totally minus 60, 2 minus 60i, and here t terms, here plus 3 t, here minus 1 t, so we get plus 2 t terms. Next to k terms, minus t, how much? Minus 2 t into k, so t belongs to r. So this is the first question answer. If you write up to t here also, no problem. This is extra steps. If you write, that is better, my suggestion. Let us take second question. Sorry, in this explanation, 3k into 1 minus t. 3 minus 3t. 3 minus 3t. So minus 3t minus t becomes minus 4t. Okay? Next, ninth question, find the vector equation of the plane passing through the points I minus 2j plus 5k, minus 5j minus k, minus 3i plus 5k. So here 1, 2, 3 points are given. So given that, let I am taking the first point is A, I minus 2j plus 5k. Second point, capital B of B, taken as minus 5j minus 5k. And third point, capital C of C, taken as minus 3i plus 5k. So 3 points are given. So that's why he mentioned in the question plane. Three vectors are mentioned, means plane equation. Okay. Passing through 3 points, what is the formula? R bar equal 1 minus t minus s into a bar plus t into b bar plus s into c bar. This is the vector equation formula where t and s belongs to real numbers. So R bar equal, we can take 1 minus T minus S into A. What is A? I minus 2J plus 5K. And plus T into B. B means what? Minus 5J minus K. Plus S into C means what? Minus 3I plus 5K. What about T and S? T comma S belongs to real numbers. That's it. This is the answer of this question. Okay. If you have more interested, you can proceed like what are the I coefficient, what are the J coefficients, what are the K coefficient. If you write still here also, we can get full 2 marks. Actually, this is the answer. Okay. Next, 10th one. Find the vector equation of the line passing through the line 2i plus j plus k and parallel to the vector 4i minus 2j plus 3k. So here, passing through the point. So passing through the point and parallel to vector. What is the formula? Passing through single point means A plus parallel to vector means TB. So what is formula? R equal to A plus TB. That's it. So here, given that the point is taken as A, 2i plus j plus k, and parallel vector that is taken as only B bar, that is 4i minus 2j plus 3k. So therefore, vector equation passing through A of A and parallel to small b bar is what? Is R equal to A plus T B bar. A bar plus T. What is T? T belongs to real number. So R bar equal to A means what? 2i plus j plus k plus some t into b bar means what? 4i minus 2j plus 3k. So this is the answer. That's it. What is t? T belongs to R. If you are interested to write, you can write 2 plus 4t into i 1 plus. Okay, no? I am splitting here. Actually, no need. 2i plus j plus k t into 4t. 4ti t into minus t. Minus 2tj t into 3k. So 3tk. So r bar equal in this 2i and 4ti. We can take I common. Then remaining is 2 plus 4t. And j terms. Here j term 1. Here j term minus 2t. So 1 minus 2t. And k terms. Here k term 1 is there. Here k terms 3t is there. So what is t? T belongs to real number. Okay. These are extra steps. This is the answer. What is the answer? Small r equal 2i plus j plus k plus t into 4i minus 2j minus 3 plus 3k is the answer. Okay. Next, 11th question. OABC is a parallelogram. If OA equal to A, OC equal to C, then find vector equation of side BC. Here, OABC is a parallelogram. Parallelogram means opposite sides are parallel and equal. So, this diagram is given. And the information, the sides, what is given? OA is given small a. And OC is given as small c. Here, what is OA? What is OC? Before that, what we have to find? We should find equation of BC. Equation of BC. So, the BC is passing through B and C. Am I right? Yes. But which point is given here? OB is not given. OC is given. So, BC is passing through C means capital C, passing through capital C. What is position of vector capital C? That is OC. Position of vector of capital C is OC. So that's why BC is passing through OC. And BC is parallel to OA. Am I right? And parallel to OA. Okay. So we got it here. Passing point to OC means small c, parallel vector OA means small a. So therefore, vector equation of BC passing through C and parallel to, okay. So therefore, the vector equation of BC is, side BC is small r equal to, actually formula is passing through vector A plus parallel to vector B bar. Actually, this is the formula. So, here passing point is, what is passing point? OC. So, passing point is OC and parallel vector is what? OA. So, we can change the formula as R bar equal to OC plus T into OA. This is passing point, this is parallel vector. OC means what? Small c. T into OE means what? Small e, where T belongs to Kepler. So this is very, very important question. Okay, for 2 marks, very simple question. Okay, next 12th question. Find the equation of the plane passing through the points 2i plus 4j plus 2k, 2i plus 3j plus 5k and parallel to the vector 3i minus 2j plus k. See here the plane passing through 2 points and parallel to some c vector. So what is the equation of passing through 3 points, passing through 2 points? That is 1 minus t into a plus t into b. So this is passing through 2 points and parallel to third vector means SC. Okay, this is passing through 2 points formula and additional to parallel to other vector means SC. Other after T, yes, after B, yes. So what about T and S? This belongs to capital R. Okay, coming to the point, what is the given that 2 points are given? One is A of A, let A of A, that is 2i plus 4j plus 2k, and B of B, second point is taken as 4 2i plus 3j plus 5k, and vector, third vector, parallel vector is 3i minus 2j plus k. So therefore, the vector equation of plane passing through 3 points A of A comma B of B and parallel to vector small c bar is, what is the formula? Small r bar equal to 1 minus t into a plus tb plus tc. Then for answer is r bar equal to 1 minus t into a. A means what? So 2i plus 4j plus 2k plus t into b means what? 2i plus 3j plus 5k plus s into c. C means what? 3i minus 2j plus k. What about t comma s? Belongs to r. This is the answer, very simple. Just if you remember the formula, we can write the answer. That's it. Only 2 steps are important. So given points, write formula, substitute in that. That's it. Next 13th, if small a comma small b comma small c are position vectors of vertices capital A, capital B, capital C of triangle ABC respectively. Find the vector equation of median through capital A. Okay. So suppose ABC is a triangle. ABC is a triangle. What is the position vector of A? Small a. So given that position vector of capital A is, that is OA equal to small a. And similarly, position vector of B, what is that? OB is small b. Similarly, position vector of C is OC, that is given as small c. This is a given information. What he is asking? He is asking to find vector equation of median through capital A. Median through capital A means, first to bisect the opposite side, we should bisect. So midpoint of B and C, that is D, and the line joining A and midpoint, that is called median. Median means it is a line from vertex to the midpoint of its opposite side. So this is small b, position vector. Position of vector of small c is capital C, small c. Then what will be the midpoint of B and C? We get small b plus small c by 2 in vectors. Okay, so A, we know that is position vector of capital A is small a. So point A we know, point D also we know. If you know 2 points, what is the vector equation? Yes, very good. 1 minus t into A plus t into B. Okay, that is the equation of vector. Okay, so here 2 points are we know. Okay, na? So first of all, midpoint of BC is equal to small d, that is, what is that? B plus C by 2. So therefore, the vector equation passing through capital A of A and D of B plus C by 2 is, what is the formula actually? R bar equal to 1 minus T into A plus T into B. Okay, what about T? Belongs to a real number. So R equal 1 minus T into A means A only, plus T into B means what? B plus C by 2. So where T belongs to real number. Okay, simple, this is the answer. Next 14th one, E is, IS is, the triangle formed by the vectors 3i plus 5j plus 2k and 2i minus 3j minus 5k and minus 5i minus 2j minus 3k equilateral triangle. Okay, question is asking, is, helping verb is, first, is the following vector, is the following triangle is equilateral triangle? Yes or no? How can we say? First of all, equilateral triangle means what? All sides must be equal. All sides must be equal. So, AB is equal to BC is equal to CA. The length of AB, length of BC, length of CA must be equal. Then we can say that equilateral. Which are given? The triangle formed by the vectors. So, vectors are given. One is 3i plus 5j plus 2k. Another one is 2i minus 3j minus 5k. Another one is minus 5i minus 2j plus 3k. Okay, actually no need to write there. So, to understand, I have written. So, AB is given, BC is given, CA is given in the vector formation. How can we find this length? How can we find this magnitude? Yes, very good. Modulus AB find out. We can get the length of AB. Similarly, modulus BC find, we can get length of B. Okay. So, let vertices R, vertices R, capital A comma, capital B comma, capital C. Therefore, given that one is capital AB, first one is taken as capital AB, 3i plus 5j plus 2k, and second one is capital BC, that is taken as 2i minus 3j minus 5k, and third one is CA or AC, we can write anyway, minus 5i minus 2j plus 3k. So, I am going to find the three vector magnitude. One, modulus AB means modulus 3a plus 5j plus 2k. So, which is equal to root of 3 square plus 5 square plus 2 square. So, which is equal root of 3 square means 9, 5 square means 25, 2 square means 4. How much it is? 9 plus 25, 34 plus 4, 38. So, AB we got it, modulus AB 38. This length AB got root 38. Similarly, modulus BC. Modulus BC means modulus 2i minus 3j minus 5k. So, which is equal to root of 2 square plus minus 3 whole square plus minus 5 whole square. Even it is minus, it becomes plus. Because of why? Minus into minus plus. That's why. Minus 3 whole square is minus 3 into minus 3 plus 9. Minus 5 whole square is plus 25. We get root 38. 4, 9, 13 plus 25 root 38. Next, modulus CA. So, modulus CA is what? Modulus minus 5i minus 2j plus 3k. So, which is equal to root of what we can get? Minus 5 square minus 2 square plus 3 square. So, which is equal to minus 5 whole square means 25. Minus 2 whole square means 4. 3 square means 9. So, which is equal to root 38. So, finally, we got it. Modulus AB equal to modulus BC is equal to modulus CA. That means what? In generally, in the geometry part, simply we can write AB means the distance formula root of x1 minus x2 whole square, y1 minus y2 whole square. But in the vectors, same way, we have to take modulus to get directly what is AB length, what is BC length, what is CA length. So, therefore, A comma ABC is an equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle. This is the answer. Next, 15th question. Same type of question is there, 16th one. I will give you for your practice or homework. So, this time, this question sometimes asked for 4 marks problems also. Because of same type of 4 marks problems also available. But small difference is there. First of all, listen here, complete this. That is, if small a comma, small b comma, small c are non-coplanar vectors, then test for collinearity of the following points whose position vectors are given by a minus 2b plus 3c, 2a plus 3b minus 4c, minus 7b plus 10c. See, the given 3 points are the position vectors of some another point. So, what is small a, small b, small c are non-coplanar vectors. So, in the solution, given that, let a position vector of position vector of capital A is taken as OA is equal to what? First vector A minus 2B plus 3C. Similarly, position vector of capital B bar means that is capital OB is 2A plus 3B minus 4C. Next, finally, position vector of capital C is OC equal minus 7B plus 10C. So we should find what is AB, what is BC. First of all, two vectors I am going to find. One is AB means OB minus OA, and second one is AC means OC minus OA. After that I will compare both terms. Okay, OB means what? The second vector, 2A plus 3B minus 4C, and minus means minus. OA, OA means what? A minus 2B plus 3C. So which is equal 2A plus 3B minus 4C, minus into A, minus into minus 2B plus 2B, minus into plus 3C minus 3C. So which is called A terms, here 2A are there, here minus 1A is there. So we get only 1A. Okay, by subtracting 1A from 2A, we get 1A. Next B terms, here 3B, here 2B, so total 5B. And C terms, here minus 4C, here minus 3C is minus 7C. So AB is A plus 5B minus 7C. Next, similarly find AC. AC means what? OC minus OA. OC means what? Minus 7B plus 10C. And minus means minus. OA means what? A minus 2B plus 3C. So which is called minus 7B plus 10C. Minus into A, minus into minus plus 2B. Minus into plus minus 3C. So which is called A terms, only minus 1A. And B terms, here minus 7B, here plus 2B, we get minus 5B. And C terms, 7C. Okay. So we have to compare these two AB and AC coefficients. AB and AC coefficients. So comparing the coefficients of ABC. Comparing ABC coefficients. So that implies here A coefficient is 1, by here A coefficient is minus 1. Here B coefficient is 5, by here B coefficient is minus 5. Here C coefficient is minus 7, by here C coefficient is plus 7. So gets cancelled, we get completely minus 1 equal minus 1 equal minus 1. Means comparison of ABC coefficients equal. So therefore what we can say, therefore the AB, AC are coplanar, therefore ABC are collinear, therefore point A comma B comma C are collinear. So this is the answer. Similarly, I will give you same type of question. You do this same, first write position vector OE, OB, OC, next find AB and AC, compare both in, you can get collinear. Okay, next to 16th question, same type of question, just I will change the vectors. Okay, same as well you do, that is 3a minus 4b plus 3c, 3a minus 4b plus 3c, and minus 4a plus 5b minus 6c, and final vector, finally 4a minus 7b plus 6c. Okay, test for about the collinearity of these vectors also. In the same process, do it, you can get the answer. We will get minus 7 equal to minus 3 equal to minus 3 you get. So answer does not, it doesn't satisfy, that's why not collinear. Answer is not collinear. It is asking for test the collinearity. After testing, if we get equal, then we can write collinear. If you do not get not equal, we should write not collinear. That's it. Do it. Okay, next 4 mass questions. Okay, 2 mass questions are completed. So in this part 2 only, we started 4 mass questions. Then the next part 3, we can complete this chapter. Let ABCDEF is a regular hexagon, then show that AB plus AC plus AD plus AE plus AF is equal 3AD is equal 6AO. Hexagon means what? Triangle means 3 sides, quadrilateral means 4 sides, square, pentagon means 5 sides, hexagon means 6 sides. And regular means what? 6 equal sides. That is called regular hexagon. So first we should draw the regular hexagon. Then we can understand the next two. Okay, it is a regular hexagon. See all the sides equal. A, B, C, D, E, F. In orderly we have to write. A, B, C, D, E, F. In middle, center is there. That is the AD midpoint. or BE midpoint or FC midpoint. We can think anywhere. So this is O. Now see, take LHS. What is LHS? AB plus AC plus AD plus AE plus AF. In part 1 we did one question, this type of question, same type of question. We should get AD, 3 AD. So already 1 AD is there. So keep it as easily. Next remaining we should convert into AD, AD, AD. See, this is AB. AB is there. Next is to get AD, BD is there in this? No. Okay. AB. Take AC and okay. So manaki, so we don't have in terms of D terms. So we should convert in terms of D's. Already it is AD, this is fixed. Okay. Here AB, instead of AB, we can write is equal to ED. Am I right? Instead of AB is equal to ED. Because of in hexagon, all sides are equal. AB equal to ED. Plus AC. So AC means we can write, okay. Next AE. AE means what? No, nothing change. AF. AF is a side. So instead of AF side, we can write CD. AF instead of, we can write CD. See, we just change the sides only. AC is not a side, so no, we can't change. AE also is not a side, it is a some diagonal, we can't change. So keep right as is, AC plus AE. So now see, AC plus CD means A to C, C to D becomes what? We get AD. So I'm writing at this side, AC plus CD at time. This AD as usually. Next to AE to ED. So we can get AD, AE plus ED. So here, since we just changed AB equal to ED, we used. Next, here AF equal to CD we used. Because of in regular hexagon, all sides are vacant. So now AC plus CD means what? AD. AD as well. Next, AE plus ED. A to E plus E to E means AD. AD. AC plus CD. AC plus CD becomes AD. Next, AE plus ED. AE plus ED becomes AD. Okay. Finally, how many ADs? 3 ADs is got it. So, one thing we can get. Equation 1. Okay. So, next to continue. In AD means, we should convert into of AO. AO is the half of AD. Am I right? So, AD equal to AO plus OD. So, AO and OD also same as to AO. So, AO plus AO, 2AO. So, since AD means we can write 2AO. So, AD means 2AO. 3 to 6AO. So, got it equation 2. So, from 1 and 2, what we can write? Therefore, from equation 1 and 2, we can write AB plus AC plus AD plus AE plus AF equal 3AD is equal 6AO. So, this is also important question for 4 marks. Next, second 4 marks question. In a triangle ABC, if O is circumcenter, H is orthocenter, then show that first one OA plus OB plus OC is equal to OH. Second one HA plus HB plus HC is equal to HO. Okay. First two, what is circumcenter? What is orthocenter? In a triangle, suppose let it take this is a triangle ABC. Triangle ABC. In this triangle, circumcenter and orthocenter. What is circumcenter? O is circumcenter. What is orthocenter? H is orthocenter. Orthocenter means what? The perpendicular bisectors of the concurrency of the perpendicular bisectors of three sides, that is called orthocenter H. Circumcenter means what? Which is equidistant to all vertices. Okay, we can get okay, I'm just drawing a rough diagram. So orthocenter means circumcenter means what? So, circumcenter here I am taking, which is circumcenter equidistant to all vertices, and orthocenter I am taking like here. Okay, this is called D. See, the relation between circumcenter and orthocenter is, the relation between circumcenter and orthocenter is 2 into OD equal to 2 into OD equal to AH. Means the distance from ortho center to midpoint of BC of two times is equal to vertex to ortho center. Okay, circumcenter to midpoint. So what is first two? Take first one. What is first one? LHS. What is LHS? OA plus OB plus OC. So before that, first one is called OH. We have to prove this. So proof. For this, we should find what is D. So D is midpoint of B and C. Am I right? So first, let OA equal to small a, OB equal to small b, OC equal to small c. Here D is midpoint of BC. So D equal to OD equal to midpoint of BC means what we can write? Small b plus small c by 2. If it is b of small b, it is c of point c. So we can get the midpoint is b plus c by 2. One 2 mass question also we have done in the same process. So OD. So that is OD, which is called B means what? B means capital OB plus small c means what? Capital OC by 2. So therefore, here I'm writing, therefore OD we can write OB plus OC by 2. Or if you extend one more step, 2 center right side, 2 into OD equal 2 OD is equal to OB plus OC. So keep it, this will be useful in the problem solving. So first one LHS I'm taking. For first question, LHS I am taking. So here no need to write first one. Just to prior information I gathered. So now I am taking first question. What is first question? OA plus OB plus OC is equal to OH. In this I am taking LHS, that is OA plus OB plus OC. So OA means OA. OB plus OC means what? From equation 1, OB plus OC means what? 2 OD. 2 OD. So now which is called OA plus 2 into OD means what? Okay, now this is the just condition, we have to remember this. Okay, simply say this there, we should remember this one. Okay, and alternately, if you don't have an idea about this problem solving, we cannot get in the examination. So before going to exam, once you see this problem, because of there is a most chance to forget this solution. That's why we have to remember 2 OD equal to AH condition, and this actually we can do very simple. Midpoint D means midpoint of B and C, that is B plus C by 2 means OB plus OC by 2. From that OB plus OC equal 2 OD. So OB plus OC equal 2 OD. Again 2 OD means what? AH. So now O to H and O to H plus A to H. Sorry, this is O to A plus, sorry, this is A, no? Yeah. O to A plus A to H completely we get. O to A plus A to H is becomes OH. Got it? First one? Yes, first one RHS we got it. Clear? Is it clear? Okay. If you have any doubt, watch again. And take the second one. Can I remove this? Yes. So after continuation of that, for second one, what is second question? HA plus HB plus HC is equal to HO. I am taking LHS of second one, that is HA plus HB plus HC is the LHS. HA means we can write OA minus OH plus HB means position of vector B minus position of vector HU. HC means OC minus OH. So here OA, OB, OC, first I am writing OA plus OB plus OC at a time. And remaining OH, 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 3 OH terms are there. So 3 OH. Okay. So now what is OA plus OB plus OC from first one? Yes, that is OH. That is OH. Minus 3 OH. So subtract 1 OH from 3 OHs, we get minus 2 OH. See, in the vectors, opposite direction of vector minus OH is equal to plus HO. Am I right? So we can write 2 into minus OH. So 2 into minus OH can be written as HO. Cut it RHS. So LHS is equal to RHS, hence proved. So this is the 4 marks. This is also important question, but the special categories, we should remember this solution sometimes, because there is a more chance to forget this answer. That's why keep some special concentration on this problem. Then the remaining problems are, so very simply we can solve. So see the one more question. Okay, in 4 marks, just those two are first and second are little bit theoretical problems. The remaining all problematic solve. So then the remaining next 4, 5, 6 are very, very easy and very most important problems we can learn in the next part 3. So within part 1, part 2, part 3, in 3 parts we can complete this chapter. Okay, solution, third one. What is the question here? If alpha bar equal x plus 4y into a bar plus 2x plus y plus 1 into b bar and beta bar equal y minus 2x plus 2 into a bar plus 2x minus 3y minus 1 into b bar are two vectors such that 3 alpha equal to beta, then find value of x and y. Okay, just a simple simplification this is. What do we have to find? First find 3 alpha value and 2 beta value. We should equate this 3 alpha and 2 beta. By solving x and y values, we can get answer. So take what is given, alpha equal to given x plus 4y into a bar plus 2x plus y plus 1 into b bar. And beta bar is given as y minus 2x plus 2 into a bar plus 2x minus 3y minus 1 into b bar. What is the given condition? Given that 3 alpha equal 2 beta condition is given. So 3 alpha means 3 into alpha. What is alpha? X plus 4y into a plus 2x plus y plus 1 into b. And is equal means is equal, 2 means 2. And beta, what is beta? Y minus 2x plus 2 into a plus 2x minus 3y minus 1 into b bar. So 3 into alpha is equal 2 into beta. We should simplify this. Okay, now completely. What are the a coefficients? So complete. 3 into x. Multiply inside. 3 into x. 3x. 3 into 4y. 12y. Into a as it is, I'm writing. Into a as it is, I'm writing. Next to 3 into 2x. 6x. 3 into y. 3y. 3 into 1. 3. Into b bar. Okay. No need to multiply 3 into b. Because of, suppose 3 into some a plus 2b is there. How can we multiply? 4a is there. 3, 4, 12a. But don't write, don't apply 3, 4, 12, 3 into a, 3a, we don't write now. Like that. 3 into 2x plus y plus 1 we can do. If you do for this, no need to do 3 into b. B bar means b bar simply. Now 2 into y. 2y. 2 into minus 2, minus 4x, 2 into plus 2, 4, a bar, plus 2 into 2, 4x, 2 into minus 3, minus 6y, 2 into minus 1, minus 2, b bar. Okay, we got both terms. Now, to simplify this, I am equating a coefficients and b coefficients. I am comparing a coefficients, comparing b coefficients, whatever we can write. So, I am writing equating a coefficients. Both sides, not only a, equating a and b coefficients both sides. First of all, a coefficients, what are the a coefficient here? 3x plus 12y, and is equal, their a coefficient is what? 2y minus 4x plus 4. Simplify this, minus 4x bring left side, first 3x plus 12y has easily write down, minus 4x bring left side becomes plus 4x, plus 2y bring left side becomes minus 2y, plus 4 bring left side minus 4 equals 0. Now, 3x plus 4x, how much? 7x. 12y minus 2y becomes plus 10y. Plus 4 minus 4. Okay, nothing. Constant is minus 4 equals 0. Equation 1. We got a equation 1 in terms of x and y. Similarly, equating b coefficients, here I am doing. Equating b coefficient, vector b coefficients. So, what are the b coefficient here? 6x plus 3y plus 3 is equal. Here b coefficient is 4x minus 6y minus 2. So now bring all left side. First right as easily in the left count terms. So 4x bring left side becomes minus 4x. Minus 6y bring left side becomes 6y. Minus 2 bring left side becomes plus 2 equals 0. So now 6x minus 4x how much? Yes, very good, 2x. And 3y plus 6y how much? 9y. And plus 3 plus 2 how much? 5 equals 0. Equation 2. So, we got two equations in variable x and y. After simplifying this, solving this, we can get the answer. Very simple. How can we simplify? Yes, here I am doing. You know, I think how to simplify. So, in many times, we used the simplified two linear pair of equations is given. We can use substitution method, elimination method, cross elimination, okay, cross multiplication method, any method we can use. So simple method is solving 1 and 2, x, y, 1 constant. Okay, see from equation 1, after this next continuation here, from equation 1, middle term 10, next minus 4, 10, minus 4, next 7, 10, 7, 10. So we should write in this way. Next 9, 5, 2, 9, 9, 5, 2, 9. So therefore x by cross multiplication, 10 into 5, 50, minus 9 into minus 4, minus 36, is equal to y by minus 4 into 2, minus 8, minus 5 into 7, 35. Is equal to 1 by 7 into 9, 63, minus 2 into 10, 20. Okay, am I right? Next, x by minus into minus plus, we get x by 86. Is that right? Is anything wrong? Okay, so y by c, minus 35 minus 8 becomes what? Minus 43. Is equal to 1 by 43 minus 20, 63 minus 20, 43. So equating first and last, we can get x by 86 is equal to 1 by 43. Then x is equal to 86 by 43. Simply 43, 1 by 43. So then x is equal to 2. Got it? One answer. Next, equating second and third means y by minus 43 equal to 1 by 43. So y equal to minus 43 by 43. Okay. So y equal to minus 1. Got it? X and y values? Yes. So these are the 3-4 mass questions. So next to 4th question onwards, we can discuss in the next part 3. So those are very, very important. Friends, if till not now subscribe, please subscribe immediately and click the bell button. See, after clicking the bell button, you will get 2 options, all and personalized. And again click all. Then whatever video I will upload, immediately you can get through in your phone. Then it is easy to watch you. Otherwise, you have to search suppose if you want to matrices part 3. How can we get? Please search matrices part 3 by Nagaraju sir. If you want to trigonometry part 7. How can we? Trigonometric ratios part 7 by Nagaraju sir. Search, you will get the answer. Okay. Otherwise, you please go to my video classes, all videos. In there, you can get whatever class you require also. So, thank you for watching my videos. And please subscribe and click bell button and share with your friends and click like button and give comments whatever you feel. Thank you. Thank you very much.